Welcome guys, a lot of you have been asking me to make a video on MG3 vs Groza vs MK14, since all these three weapons are extremely powerful which makes them really hard to choose. So in this video, we will do a comparison, to figure out which one is the best. Anyway, each weapon here has its own category. For example, MG3 is a light machine gun, Groza is an assault rifle, and the MK14 is a designated marksman rifle also known as DMR. Which differentiates each weapon, and also makes it easier to choose which kind of weapon you want to use. We all know that MK14 is the most powerful gun in this game. It can literally scare people just by its sound, but let's see if it's still the strongest one. So here is the damage information of all three guns. So the MG3 has the base damage of 40, which is the lowest among all, whereas the Groza has base damage of 48, same damage as an AKM, and the MK14 has a base damage of 61, the highest in any fully automatic gun. And here is the rest of the damage depending on where you hit. So obviously MK14 has the highest damage per bullet, so does it mean the MK14 is still the strongest weapon in this game? Well yes, but actually no, because some weapons can make up for it by shooting extremely faster. So we gotta test out the rate of fire, or the firing speed of the weapons. To make it easier for you to understand, I'm gonna tell you how many bullets it can fire in just 1 second. So the MK14 can fire approximately 11 bullets per second, and I think MK's rate of fire is very similar or identical to M416, and the Groza can fire up to 12.5 bullets per second, and lastly the MG3, it can fire up to 16.5 bullets per second. So we can clearly see that MG3 has a faster firing speed, meaning it can fire 50 to 60% faster than MK14. So can MG3 make up for the low damage by shooting faster? Well, let's find that out in DPS, which stands for damage per second. This will tell us exactly how powerful the weapons are. To calculate the DPS, we have to multiply the base damage into the rate of fire, then we'll get the DPS. So by looking at these numbers, the MK14 has the highest damage per second of 671, quickly following by MG3. With 660 DPS, that's like 1 to 2% less than MK14, and the Groza has 600 DPS, which is the lowest, but trust me, it's not bad as you think. For example, the M416 has only 450 DPS, that's like 33% lower damage per second, when compared next to Groza. Anyway, it only requires 100 damage to take down your opponent, since they only have 100 health, so imagine what you could do by doing over 600 plus damage in a second. By the way, these numbers are only relevant when all the bullets hits the target. Missing few bullets will make everything fall apart, especially in a game where the recoil is totally random. So here is the side-by-side recoil comparison of MG3 versus Groza versus MK14. Here's a quick note, MK14 can only shoot 20 bullets in a single spray, so if we only do 20 rounds for all guns, this is how it looks. So there is no doubt that MK14 has the highest recoil here. I mean, sometimes the spray will go left and right totally in an unpredictable way, so you would most likely miss all your shots. I would say MK14 will be the hardest weapon to handle or control. And the MG3 has the lowest recoil, lower than all the assault rifles, including M4 and AUG etc. Its recoil is kinda similar to SMGs, but however, the MG3's recoil tends to move horizontally way too much, which can be a huge problem. But since it has very low recoil, it won't be a huge deal. I would say MG3 is one of the easiest weapon to use, for spraying at any distance. And now to the Groza. Groza doesn't have too much recoil or too low recoil, it's kinda in between or perfectly balanced. I would say Groza's recoil is not too hard to control or too easy to control, it requires some practicing, and then you're good to go. Anyway, do you know that crouching will reduce your recoil while spraying? Well, I tested that, and now comparing side by side, if you look at Groza and MK14, it only got reduced by around 10 to 15%. While the MG3's recoil got reduced by almost 50%. Literally, crouching will reduce half of your recoil with MG3. That's the LMG advantage you get with MG3. This is why crouching and spraying is an extremely important skill to learn in this game. But still, 10 to 15% recoil reduction while crouching is also really useful. It's like using an extra compensator to your gun. And now moving on to the bullet velocity. I think the MK14 and MG3 has a similar or identical bullet velocity, and that is around 850 meters per second, while the Groza has a slightly lower bullet velocity, around 715 meters per second, or same as an AKM's bullet velocity. And now to the final conclusion on which weapon is the best. It's really hard to say which gun is the best, because every weapon has its pros and cons, so let's go through them, starting with MK14's pros. It's the strongest weapon in this game, or basically it has highest damage output, and that is it. Now the cons, very high recoil, extremely difficult to handle this gun, low magazine size, so you can't fight against more than one enemy at the same time, and must have extended magazine for MK14. Moving on to the MG3's pros, very low recoil, easy to control this weapon. If you use crouch, recoil will be even more easier to handle, and if you go prone, you will literally get zero recoil. It may not have high damage, but it can make up for it by firing so fast, faster than MP5K I guess. So overall this weapon can do almost the same damage as an MK14 by shooting faster. And now to the cons. I don't think this weapon has any cons, unless PUBG adds some in the next update. But if you have any cons with this weapon, let me know in the comments. I guess maybe reloading might be a con, but can't complain since it's an LMG, it should have higher reloading time. Anyway, moving on to the Groza's pros, it's actually the most powerful assault rifle in this game. It deals high damage and has decent recoil and very reliable weapon. And now to the cons, everything about Groza is perfectly balanced. But if it can accept a muzzle attachment like compensator, or any grip attachment, it would be way better, and finding that suppressor is kinda hard, I wish they put an inbuilt suppressor like VSS, it would be a stealthy weapon. So which one is the best? Well, I would say MK14 and MG3 both are very close in terms of being the most powerful weapon. I think MG3 is actually better, because it does what everything MK14 does, sometimes better. It can do almost the same damage per second as an MK14, while maintaining low recoil. Even noobs can control MG3's recoil. Anyway, that's all I got for this video. I hope you learned something new. If you did, hit the like button, and subscribe for more upcoming videos like these. Enjoy my bot gameplay. See you guys in the next one. Cause they know, but they know I hit the lotto. My motto, roll up gelato and throttle a couple models to Kyle, who fucking brought up the bottle. So gone hand, this ain't even luck, all planned. Y'all know who the fuck's I can, but I'm fuck smoke bands. Always been the MO since the start of this, and now I'm on a mission like an artist. We gon' turn the crib into a club like Hennessy and Buddha screaming thug like. Baby, you know I'm the plug, right? But you got a feeling that it's gonna be a long night. Make it right, 18 of those, I'm in the cave, I gotta make some light. Make it hype, even if we break the night. Even if things go left, we gotta make them right. Chillin' with mine, we triple up, they on the double up. Triple up, came from the basement, we only going up. They loving us, up in the booth, I'm getting dizzy, but they the cup is up. Toast to my people that's wanna come up and you live with us. Ain't all about the trick of us. Looking at my watch, your spirit bomb, both hands is going up. You going coast to coast with us. See the flows is flowing, overflowing, yeah, the cup it runneth over. Tidal wave up in the ocean. We gon' turn the crib into a club like Hennessy and Buddha screaming thug life. Get it, baby, you know I'm the plug, right? But we got a feeling that it's gonna be a long night.